Welcome back, USA men's national team in action in Havana, and it's goalless at halftime against Cuba. The first time the US team have visited Cuba in a friendly match since 1947. And the United States, Taylor, not in great form so far here.
No, it was a difficult first half, I think, to assess anyone, let alone the United States, Cuba as well. The field, the conditions. Both teams felt like they were stuck in first gear the entire game, and it's just a difficult game to assess. But I expect Jurgen Klinsmann most likely to make a few changes here.
Well, six substitutions for each team are allowed, of course, this being a friendly match. Good turnout in support of the match, I must say, from the population of Havana. And there's what the stats say so far.
Not sure what you want me to assess out of that one, Ian. I think the passing percentage is a very good indication of how difficult it is to knock it around. I think more often than not in the second half, you'll see the United States do what they did the last 20, 25 minutes, play direct. Ugly game, to say the least.
USA 59% of the possession so far. It hasn't looked like that, I must say, with the naked eye. What do you feel about the idea of playing this goodwill game? You can understand why the politicians like it. Diplomatic relations have been restored. There's now more trade and commerce between the two nations after the long Cold War years.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have any issue whatsoever with that. I just think if you're going to schedule a friendly, you've got to make sure the conditions, and I'm not talking about the weather or the stadium. I'm talking about the field. You've got to get something out of the game. In the goodwill game, I get it, Ian. And honestly, I go back to that point I made in the first half. It's very difficult right now for the United States to schedule friendlies. So you can argue about the competition level and whatnot, but that's neither here nor there. If you're going to play the friendly, I mean, Ian, would you have an issue if the game was played on turf right now compared to that first half? Well, I'd rather have the game on turf.
It would be better than this surface. It would be better than this surface, that's for certain. By the way, we saw some of the substitutes warming up there, and one of them is an interesting character, Lyndon Gooch, who has featured in Sunderland's team in the Premier League so far. Indeed, they started the first four games for Sunderland this season, playing wide on the left of midfield. So I wonder whether he'll be given his debut in this second half. Probably he will be, you would think. Be a chance for Jurgen Klinsmann to have a look at him. I think it's fair to say, if it is his debut, he won't forget it here. Chris Wondolowski coming on, who keeps on getting double-digit figures in terms of goals in Major League Soccer. He's the first player, I think, to do it 7 years
running.
Yeah, it's very good, isn't it? 11th goal of the season for him. Timmy Chandler also being introduced here. We'll try to keep you abreast of all these different changes. Steve Birnbaum will go into central defence now. It is a bit of a moving feast in the second half, like all the changes in the chorus line. So Cuba in their all red outfit to get us underway at the start of the second half with their striker Michael Reyes. And at times in the first half, Cuba put together one or two decent moves, which belies their lowly status in world football, ranked 139. The USA are currently at number 22. Could change again. That's aimed towards Reyes and cut out by Birnbaum, who's made a pretty good impression when he's been used so far. The DC United defender, including scoring a winner against Iceland. Here's Julian Green. Long towards Altidore. Wood! Chance! Not taken.
And I felt if there was one bright spot in the first half, I felt it was Julian Green in those two, three opportunities he had going forward. Here's another great one, delivering a ball to Josie Altidore.
Great chance, really, for the U.S. to take the lead. That's Yasmani Lopez, who's down injured.
It's a great ball forward from Julian Green, and Josie Altidore doing everything he can to give Bobby Wood an opportunity.
He's very upset at not taking that.
Well, any cold scorer would be.
Wood's last eight USA appearances have been starts. So he's pretty much a part of the furniture now up front. Here's Birnbaum. By the way, the players who've gone off so far, Pulisic, Brooks and Yedlin. Wood trying to flick that one on. Yes, they're just pressing a little higher at the start of the half, noticeably. Timmy Chandler has had a strange career with the US. In favour, out of favour, seems to have been out of favour more than in.
There's part of me that thinks this may be his last shot. And I'm not talking about the game today.
We've said that before, haven't
we? But we have. Now, this year, though, he played against Darmstadt at center back, so I'm wondering if that versatility, maybe Jurgen looks at it and says, I think Timmy Chandler hasn't proven to get called in every single camp, particularly in World Cup qualifiers. So I do believe this is the last shot, particularly under Jurgen Klinsmann.
So he's got a half here to maybe just make a little case. Did go to the World Cup in Brazil, Timmy Chandler, but never got on the pitch. He was quite upset about that and got into a bit of an argument with Andreas Herzog, I seem to remember, after the last game.
Yeah, you and I watched that right after they lost to Belgium.
The other player who didn't get on in that squad was Mix Diskerud, who's fallen away a little in terms of the USA team just at the moment. Gomez's long ball went an awful long way. And it's hammered well wide by the Cubans, who do have trouble scoring. That was Reyes, as we were saying. They haven't scored in 9 of their last 10 matches. Here's Michael Bradley for the US in a game that they really should be winning, and pretty comfortably. On paper, anyway. Saez. It's played long towards Green, who's in a bit of space out on the left-hand side. Bradley. Sasha Kljestan. His job to try to pick the passes to open up the defences. Chandler's ball in, it beat everybody. Wood, Altidore, the lot.
Well, now they've got a little bit of a different look with Wondolowski playing as a right midfielder or even as a third striker. Now when the ball goes wide, they've got Josie, they've got Bobby Wood and Chris Wondolowski trying to get on the end of that cross. Thought it was interesting. 3 days ago, Jurgen had to answer the questions of why Chris Wondolowski still gets called into this team. And he said he's a huge part of the locker room and the team makeup. But Ian, at some point you need to ask your question, is it better to bring maybe a young player along that could gain the experience? But then again, Chris Wondolowski has been Jurgen Klinsmann's man, being in that locker room and being a real leader both on and off the field for the younger players.
He's 33 now, the San Jose Earthquake striker. He was another one that went to the World Cup. He had that wonderful chance late on against Belgium, which might have won the game. Game just opening up a little here. Cuba tucking down with Gomez down that left-hand side. Cardenas in really of not making the cross count. Altidore taking a knock. How about that for a warm-up area?
That looks like you this morning at the hotel.
I'm not usually that energetic, particularly with jet lag. Reyes goes down. Referee was close, saw nothing wrong with that at all. Altidore to feed it wide. Wood waiting in the middle. Chandler's ball in, and the goalkeeper claims it confidently.
I know we've talked about it, Ian, for 52 minutes, but how many times is that ball going to bounce? I mean, look at the ball, just can't roll flat.
That, nothing was given for that. No free kick, Birnbaum's challenge. It was a free kick, wasn't it?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, should have been anyway.
But I wanted to finish my point about how bad the field was.
Oh, right. Okay, the field again. Yep, it's bad. It's definitely bad, Taylor. It's Fabian Johnson. It's been a fabulous addition to the team, really, since Jürgen Klinsmann took over. And he's another one who's played a number of positions, both fullback positions, midfield. Klesjan looking to find the right ball. It's a decent one for Timmy Chandler. Chandler does well, stands it up to the back post. Sanchez doesn't really get it away. Green shot was blocked. Opportunity, Fabian Johnson wanted a bit too much time. The block was a painful one.
Good touch from Sanchez, though, because that ball in from Chandler, you thought you had the goalkeeper beat on the back post, and Sanchez, with a little touch, throws Julian Green and Bobby Wood off. Watch this ball in here. Chandler looking for that back post. Good touch from Sanchez.
Good bit of work by Timmy Chandler.
It was.
Hanging that cross up like that. And then Green's effort was charged down by Josel Piedra. Time for some rehydration, which is much needed. In what's been a slightly strange fixture, it has to be said, in Havana here. I think Cuba would look at this, if this ends in a draw, they'd say,
of course it
that's
would.
One of our best results.
No doubt about it.
It's David Arguelles in a spot of bother. Ball did crack into him like this. Bradley. Well, the US a little more businesslike at the start of the second half. Big chance for Bobby Wood already. Another one for Julian Green.
I think some of the changes, too, from Jürgen Klinsmann were pragmatic about the field. Bring on Chris Wondolowski, bring on Chandler, and just throw numbers forward. It was a frustrating first half for Pulisic. Every touch bouncing up off his shins, his ankles. Yedlin didn't have any opportunities going forward, and I think that's why Jürgen looked at it and said, I'll bring on Chris Wondolowski, he'll bomb forward and give that space to Chandler on the right.
Of course, the USA have had some difficult trips to this part of the world since Jürgen Klinsmann took over. Defeats against Guatemala, Costa Rica, Jamaica, Honduras. Sometimes in difficult conditions.
Well, remember, Antigua Barbuda wasn't the easiest, if not for Alan Gordon coming off the bench and having a say in that one. And that's why I say this is still a good opportunity for the young players like Lyndon Gooch and Pulisic to have a good understanding for the rest of their careers of what World Cup qualifying is like in CONCACAF in the hexagonal round.
Good piece of play by Piedra. Can't hold on to the ball, though. How quickly can the USA turn this into a fast counter here?
It's also, Ian, why I think there's different rosters for CONCACAF qualifying and for the World Cup.
Klesjan trying to forge a way through there. USA, remember, have made it through to the last 7 World Cups. And that after a 40-year break when they weren't in the competition at all, not at the final stage anyway, between 1950 and 1990. And some people might say the qualification is relatively easy from CONCACAF, but they don't have to play those games in suffocating heat on horrible pitches away from home. Can be a rocky old road, and it might still be for the US. I mean, one or two twists and turns along the way, that's for certain. Green's got some space here. Three against two, he goes alone. Altidore and Wood, well, they didn't make the most of that. They had three players there against two defenders, and that was criminally wasted. That wasn't Green's best moment of the game, that's for certain. Here's Reyes. He's having a dart here, and he's hit the inside of the post, and it bounces away. The USA nearly shocked. Horvath manages to keep his clean sheet, but Reyes, good positive play.
And it catches the United States on the counter, because immediately on the other end, Julian Green, Jozy Altidore, Chris Wondolowski, 3v2, Green makes the wrong decision. And if not for that little deflection from Steve Birnbaum, that ball's in the back of the net.
Now, will that shake the USA up a little bit into some more punchy play? Gomez's cross, easily dealt with by Napolis. And there's a yellow card issued by the referee there. But all the talk is about Reyes's run a moment or two ago. I don't know whether that was for dissent. It might have been Ergeles that the referee waved a yellow card at. It was hard to be certain, really. So Jordan Morris, who's done very well in his rookie season with Seattle Sounders, to replace Bobby Wood, for whom it hasn't happened this time. Morris, another of those who's snapping at the heels a little bit of Altidore these days. He's 22.
It looked like Reyes was just offside on that deflection through the middle. But I thought Morris has been very impressive this rookie year. And it was a struggle early on, a lot of pressure on him, obviously a homegrown player for Seattle, but he's really turned the corner as of late. And a lot of it was after Clint Dempsey had to deal with his health issue. They needed Jordan Morris to step up, and he's really done that. 10 of his 12 goals for Seattle have come in the second half, big goals for them on their playoff run.
Chandler to played inside. Question. Now Bradley. Comes to Fabian Johnson. Green. Green hasn't featured, by the way, in the last 10 USA internationals before this one, not even from the bench, but he started today. And he swings in the corner now, not a good one. Cameron's effort. Nice cute little clearance, wasn't it, from the goalkeeper to Alberto Gomez, who's winning his 41st cap in midfield. Saez feeds it wide. Another Cuban attack breaks down rather too easily from their point of view. The USA have to try to turn defence into attack a little quicker. Green's got the space out on this left-hand side. Will he do better this time? Ganey wants to go alone. It wasn't the worst effort. And the USA crack the ball in the back of the net. Chris Wondolowski, that's what he does. And the USA get the lead just past the hour mark. Expert finish, his 11th goal for the USA.
Great piece of work from Julian Green on the left side, cutting in. Difficult save for Sanchez. He does anything he can to parry this wide of the goal, but Chris Wondolowski, throughout his entire career, has always been on his toes. Expect the unexpected. That's a difficult finish on this field. Chris Wondolowski scoring his 11th goal for the United States.
He made it look easy, didn't he?
He really did.
Really good professional. And that might answer your question about where Jürgen Klinsmann keeps him around in the squad. To come off the bench, you need a goal. He's liable to pop one in. I know what every USA fan is saying. Why didn't he do it that day against Belgium?
Got the credit to Chris Wondolowski for still continuing his career and persevering through all of that. Remember, within 24 hours, he owned up to it and immediately started to move on. But I think Jordan Morris and other younger players will push that position when it comes down to Russia.
Reyes making a nuisance of himself. The player has already hit the post in this game. So normal service resumed, you could say. The USA nearly always beat Cuba. They've won 9 of the 11 meetings. They've won the last 5 by a total of 35-5.
And Ian, just to put a bow on the Chris Wondolowski miss against Belgium, early on in the MLS regular season, we were in San Jose, and I asked him about that miss. He said he thinks about that miss every single day.
Well, I remember saying that at the time to you when we were commentating against Belgium. That was a sliding doors moment in his life. Yep. Every time he shuts his eyes and goes to sleep, that chance is there in front of him. But you're right, fantastic character, and credit to him to come back from all of that, because you'd have thought, well, that was it. That was it. That was the end of his international career. But it isn't, and it wasn't. At least the crowd have seen a goal here, not for the team they wanted to score. But hang on, here's Alberto Gomez playing it towards the back post. And again, it bounces down off the post. Caballero's header. He's got another opportunity. Oh, and it won't go in for the Cubans. Well,
both
close
posts in the second half, whether it's deflections, miscues with Horvath coming off his line. Unlucky for these Cuban fans in this stadium with that deflection off the post. It's a difficult ball from Gomez. It's actually a great header, headed down, back where it came from, and lucky for Horvath in the United States, it hit the post.
Yet another good chance as well there. The player who hit the post, Robin A. Caballero, with the second one, might have found the far corner of the net. The woodwork struck twice by Cuba. Will be counting themselves a little bit unlucky to be behind. They're going to make a change and bring on Duxney Espinosa. Here it is again, the Caballero header. That close. Here he is again. This is a fair opportunity.
Just wide, too.
Look at Horvath there. He's not shy. He might be making his debut, shouting out at the defenders. Gomez coming off, and on comes Espinosa. Who plays for Camagüey, which is, I'm told, the second biggest place behind Havana in Cuba. Cameron. Kane looking to go long. Altidore did his job. He won the header and got the layoff in. The USA have always had the look about them in this game of a team who just want to get the win and get on the plane and get back and get on with the next game against New Zealand and then get themselves ready for the start of the Hex next month. Again, another Cameron chip forward. Nicely played on, and the USA might get another one here. Good break forward.
Great flick on from Jordan Morris to Wondolowski, and an even better idea from Wando to play it back to Jordan Morris coming in late.
Paul Ariola is going to come on in a moment, who's scored in both of his games so far for the USA. One of only eight players to achieve that feat. The last, by the way, was Eddie Johnson in 2004.
Here's the flick on I'm talking about. Jordan Morris immediately flicking it on to Wando Turn and making that near post run. That's where the confidence of Jordan Morris has changed over the last 3 or 4 months for Seattle Sounders. His hold up play, his explosion off the turn, really coming into his own in his rookie season.
It's a bit of an old school type of ground here. It was built in 1929, this Estadio Pedro Marrero in Havana. Also stages baseball. Altidore's coming off. This was Morris latching onto it. He just wasn't quite laid into his path the way he would have wanted. Otherwise, it was probably 2-0.
Yeah, I just love the little flick on from Jordan Morris and then immediately exploding, going the other way. Part of the criticism for Jordan Morris this year has been his left foot. He's been working on it with assistant coach Ante Razov in Seattle, but it's more the confidence from Jordan Morris in the final play. We saw it in LA on our area, and he was a special player that day for Seattle to get a massive 3 points on the road.
Danny Williams plays in the championship, the second tier in England for Reading. Another player has been in and out of the squad over the last few years. In this one, and all those players will be thinking about the final 23 for the World Cup should the USA qualify, and it's not something to take for granted. There are 209 nations trying to get to Russia,
and after Infantino gets done with them, we'll be 128 in the World Cup
and they won't have to bother about the qualification. Then what are we going to do? Saez, Hernandez, another deep cross. This time Horvath has done little wrong
he
on his debut.
He looks composed, doesn't he?
And that goalkeeper position just might be up for grabs. Brad Guzan is not currently number one starter for Middlesbrough in the Premier League. Tim Howard has now come back to the United States.
And he's been a real game changer for Colorado, Ian. And I think if you're going with the hot hand, Tim Howard needs to be starting against Mexico.
That's an interesting little observation from Taylor there. Jürgen Klinsmann has to make that big decision. Wondolowski in behind here. Green is in the middle. Towards Green. He makes it 2-0. Well, a goal and now an assist for Chris Wondolowski, and Julian Green with only his second goal for his country, and now the USA have clear water.
And it's all about assessing players in the environment and assessing the situation. Chris Wondolowski has taken every bit of this chance today off the bench and made the most of it. Stays onside, controls himself, picks up his head, finds Julian Green, and Julian Green deservedly gets the goal, where he's been the most dangerous attacker today for the United States. But you have to tip your cap to Chris Wondolowski. Difficult situation. He put his head down, professional performance with a goal and assist. And Julian Green gets his second goal in the United States uniform.
Yeah, that was good from Wondolowski, and a good little message to any young boys and girls watching in that sort of situation. Got his head up, saw the better placed player. Here's Morris, nice piece of control from him that. Green's got a bit of room to work with here. Taking on everybody. Laid back and hammered well over the bar in the end. Timmy Chandler on the end of the chance. ESPN's coverage of the European qualifiers for the World Cup continues this week. On Sunday, Iceland against Turkey, Group I from Reykjavik. Tuesday on ESPN2, Slovenia against England. Coverage of both games, 2:30 Eastern, available on the ESPN app as well. Well, the USA in the box seat now. It's been pretty hard labour, but they have stepped it up in the second half and just made their extra class tell. Having said that, the Cubans have been a bit unlucky, haven't they?
They've hit the post twice.
Yeah, they have been. And maybe they'll see something to build on for the future in this performance, because there have been one or two bright spots for them and great sparks, notably Arichel Hernandez in midfield, and Saez has had a good game as well in there too. 17 minutes remaining. USA with a corner kick. Chandler won the header. The goalkeeper's distribution has been notably good, the Cuban goalkeeper. He's always thinking about getting rid of it quickly to somebody in space and getting a counter going. Goalkeepers have to be good with their feet as well these days. Ask Pep Guardiola. Lead forward towards Caballero. Has come over to the right-hand side, continues with his run. Saez is going off now, just a bit tired maybe. And on comes Deron Blanco, a defender, to take his place. We did eventually get the Cuban squad handed to us. They seem to be keeping it a secret all week, didn't they? I've never known a national team who basically wouldn't release the squad of players that they'd picked. Here's the new man, Deron Blanco, to curve this one in for the Cubans. Went a long way. And the USA looking for the quick break. Morris. Messy piece of work, really, from the US. Gave Cuba back possession of the ball. Reyes, strong and powerful, trying to cut that one back into the path of Espinosa. Quarter of an hour to go. Contador, by the way, when he went off, unable to continue his run of scoring in the last three US games he's played in. Another change for the Cubans, bringing on Peraza, a midfield player, Roberto Peraza, who plays for the club whose home is this stadium, La Habana. The Cuban league is over 100 years old. Ariola laid it inside, chipped towards the back post, nobody there in a white shirt. Well, I think Wondolowski has answered your question.
Yeah.
Quite
many of us.
Pertinently, hasn't he?
No doubt about it. And as much as we talk about the evolution of Michael Bradley and his role and changing positions, Chris Wondolowski is the same thing. He's not coming in here. He knows he's not coming into the national team and being an every game starter, but he's going to understand his role. He's going to play that role. And today, Klinsmann brought him on at halftime and said, just give us something. He's done that.
It's interesting. He started him in that game against Argentina, didn't he? Bit surprisingly, in the Copa America, of course, the Argentinians won that by 4-0. It was a bit of a lesson, that one. There have been disappointments in recent times. That playoff game against Mexico that was lost. Defeat against Jamaica in the Gold Cup. It's a dodgy period.
I think
Are they coming out the other side of that now?
Yeah, I think so. I think a lot will be determined in the display they have at home against Mexico and in Costa Rica.
Yeah, that's the acid test, isn't it?
I think the Guatemala loss, though, was really the bottom of it, Ian. But there's always been a few results. You and I didn't think we were going to Columbus in March thinking that was a must-win game when the schedule came out. But because they laid an egg in Guatemala, they had to go to Columbus and get a result, which they did.
As they often do in that city.
I think the bigger statement, Ian, is the under-23s haven't qualified for two Olympics in this frame of time.
Yeah, that is a bit of a worry.
Well, because some countries, and you and I have had this discussion many a times, where some countries don't need the Olympics, but Mexico, the United States, they need that international competition for experience.
Good pressure from the Cubans. Napoli's ball in is blocked on the way through. The USA have just been that little bit more clinical. Ethan Horvath has done his chances no harm at all. He's from Colorado, used to play for a team called Highlands Ranch there. 6'3", big goalkeeper, young goalkeeper, confident goalkeeper, and getting lots of first team football in Norway. Bradley lays it forward. Job for the US now is just to close the show here and chalk up the win. Fabian Johnson hurt, looks at the referee, thought he should have got a decision out
no
of that.
No foul? You're going to be kidding me.
Espinosa here, chance for the Cubans to get a goal back, and they still cannot take the chance.
How was that not a foul?
Well,
how is that not a foul? And look at the blood coming out of Birnbaum's head.
Are you fucking blind? Are you fucking blind?
Well, apologies if you're catching any of the industrial language from the sidelines from the microphones, but I think the gist of the message was the one that you were saying, Taylor, there, really.
Well, that's Jurgen Klinsmann on the sideline. He's 100% correct, Ian. He's 100% correct. And his argument is with the assistant referee on the near side. But now your concern is for Steve Birnbaum, because he's had concussions early on this year for DC United. This is how is this not a foul? That's a foul.
Well, it's nearly a red card.
Of course it is.
That high from Espinosa. Certainly seen players sent off for that. I'm not saying it was deliberate or anything like that, but it was certainly reckless and in danger, endangering an opponent. And those are the criteria on another day and all that. He didn't even give a free kick, the referee, Japheth Perea from Panama. The debate goes on. Michael Bradley is continuing the argument. Fact is, though, Cuba should have gone and scored once the referee waved the play on.
Right. And they've had their opportunities in the second half, but it's just mind-boggling. But how often have we seen this in CONCACAF? I mean, look at how high his left foot is. And it's not like Steve Birdbaum's coming. I mean, that is reckless.
And dangerous, you can see.
Of course it is. It's a red card.
Look at the effect. Steve Birnbaum, the player down, the defender winning his ninth cap. He plays in Major League Soccer for DC United. He did start the World Cup qualifier against Trinidad and Tobago.
And Ian, this year he's drawn some European interest. It's going to be an interesting offseason for DC United and Steve Birnbaum and what decisions he makes, because obviously he's an old-fashioned defender. He's good in the air, strong in the tackle. Simple passer of the ball. He's impressed Jurgen Klinsmann with his athleticism and the ability to defend. But it's just mind-boggling how that is not. One, he doesn't even blow his whistle. But two, there's no card.
Could he possibly play any part against New Zealand in Washington on Tuesday? That game's available on ESPN. Coverage beginning 8 Eastern on ESPN and also streaming live on the ESPN app as well. That's the USA against New Zealand on Tuesday from the RFK Stadium in Washington, D.C. By the way, in Europe in World Cup qualifiers, a couple of headlines. Cristiano Ronaldo, his form being criticized. He scored 4 for Portugal as they beat Andorra 6-0. Netherlands beat Belarus by 4-1. France beat Bulgaria 4-1. Belgium with a 4-0 win over Bosnia-Herzegovina, now managed by Roberto Martinez, latterly of this parish.
I'm just looking at the medical staff here on the sideline. There's absolutely no reason to put Steve Birnbaum back into this game.
Green's advanced his cause a little today?
I think so, Ian. Again, I don't think he's starting against Mexico at home in Columbus, and I don't think he's starting in Costa Rica, but in those few opportunities going forward, he's been dangerous, he's been dynamic, which is interesting considering he's getting no first-team play at Bayern Munich. And the entire preseason, he played as a lone striker when Lewandowski was gone. So today, going to wide left, it's a big year for Julian Green in his career. Last year of his contract at Bayern Munich. And obviously, if he wants to play with the national team, he's got to move on from there.
Here he is, right on cue. Keeps him on the radar anyway, I'd say, today. Here is Green. Bradley. Did score. Very good goal, I remember. 2010 World Cup against Slovenia. USA comeback. They were the comeback kings in that World Cup. Williams tried to thread it through. Last 5 minutes here now. Here's Blanco in the number 17 shirt, one of the many substitutes. Mistake by Fabian Johnson. Hernandez with the somewhat theatrical fall. To take it. Arichel Hernandez with the cross towards Reyes. And Napoles towards Hernandez again. Well played by Fabian Johnson, heading it away. Green. Jordan Morris there. 12 goals this season for him. That's the second most by a rookie in Major League Soccer history. Kyle Larin ahead of him with 17 last season. It's only the most by an American rookie.
Mm-hmm. With that form that Jordan Morris has shown and Nicholas Ladero coming in, Brian Schmetzer's completely turned around the Seattle Sounders. And they're getting hot at the perfect time going into the playoffs.
That's all building up very nicely in Major League Soccer. The playoffs just ahead. Do try to catch the matches with us on ESPN.
Did you turn your car off today? Come on, you've got to give the viewers the story. Come on, they've sat through 88 minutes of this game.
All right, you've got to tell the story. I left my car engine running in a car park for 3 hours.
For the viewers at home, for 20 minutes, he's like, where are my keys? Taylor, where are my keys? I can't, where are my keys? Go outside, the car's been running for 3 hours.
You do realize I'm now going to be bombarded with advice, most of which will say, maybe it's time to give up motoring. Bradley's volleyed ball. Ariola chasing it. Must be thinking this international game's easy, scoring in his first two. Plays for Tijuana, top of the table in Mexico. Cameron just got enough on that, didn't he? Cubans might regard this as a reasonably encouraging display, even though they're going to lose. They've asked a few questions, haven't they?
Especially in the first half with that high line, and they had the opportunities to break them down. Yes, they hit the post twice in the second half. But I think it's fair to say they've asked a few questions of this back line in the United States. I still believe it's difficult to assess anything out of this result, though, Ian.
It's a good volley. By Peraza.
Because if a player play bad, you say it's the field and the conditions. And then if they play well, you say, well, it's against Cuba. And so it's just, all in all, I think it's a difficult game to really assess this afternoon. Would you agree?
Yeah. Did look in the first half as if some of the players were just finding it a little bit too hot to get up for the game. Just didn't have that edge that you've got when there's more at stake. It's understandable. Is Green again on the score sheet today. Good moment for the 21-year-old. You can say it was point-blank range, but he managed to get in the right place. That's well, Taylor knows all about that.
And you said John Brooks will always remember that goal against Ghana. People forget Julian Green's got a goal at a World Cup.
Yeah.
Lucky or not, doesn't matter. That finish was a well-timed run, great ball forward, by the way. But listen, Julian Green's 21 years of age, so in the next 6-7 months, if he gets time, he makes a move to a club team. I think we're naive if we write him off at 21 years of age right now.
Well, Jurgen Klinsmann's always had a high opinion of him. He asked him a lot, I think, quite early.
Agreed.
And gave him a lot of big rave reviews to the media, which maybe put a little bit more pressure on him.
Not to mention, everyone just made the assumption it was Julian Green for Landon Donovan on the 23.
Peraza lays it wide. We're in stoppage time, of which there'll be a minimum of 3 minutes. Peraza and Hernandez! Oh! And the flag is up anyway against Hernandez, but Horvath, I think, is destined not to be beaten. It looks like a debut clean sheet for him, thanks to the two posts, it has to be said as well. don't think it's a game that's going to live long in the memory. We'll be on the show reel of highlights of U.S. soccer history, this one. But the U.S. are going to come up with the win. Areola on the far side here, closing stages.
I disagree. I think this is some of your best work.
That might not be saying much. Johnson. Flicked on by Morris. There are one or two striking options available now to Jurgen Klinsmann. Morris has made the pretty big step forward. Bobby Wood as well, of course. Pulisic, an attacking midfield player, wide player.
Doesn't all of it, though, revolve around the health of Jozy Altidorian?
It still does, yeah. But it's good that he can't take his place for granted.
Agreed.
It's good that US have the choice, and if he's injured, as he was in the first, 31 minutes of the World Cup, there are other possibilities. That's it. The USA have got the win in Havana in this goodwill friendly. It's not 5-2 to Cuba today as it was in 1947. Difficult conditions, but the USA getting the win. Chris Wondolowski scoring one, setting up the other one for Julian Green. We'll be back with more in a moment.